Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the Vue Color Picker component in a Vue application. Using the Color Picker component, you can find and pick the perfect color with its various color specifications like RGB, HSV, or hex codes. In this video, I will show you how to configure the Color Picker component in a Vue application. You will also see how to set values at the initial load, display the color picker using different modes, hide the input area, and customize the palette with user-defined colors. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue and Node.js. I edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on a supported browser. To create a project in Vue, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm create vite at latest. Then I provide the app name, my Vue app. Next, I choose Vue as the framework and JavaScript as the variant. Now the Vue project is created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vite project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Color Picker component, I install the Syncfusion Vue inputs package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vueinputs --save. This command will install the Vue inputs package with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So, I open the main.js file and import the register license method. From the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, it is required to register the Vue license key. To see how to generate this license key, refer to the link attached in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion Vue components. To start using the Color Picker component, I open the app.vue page and remove the default code. I import the Vue Color Picker component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue inputs package. Then, I register the component along with its child directives. Inside the template section, I add a division element with the ID wrapper and place the header tag, choose a color. I add the color picker component by defining the EJS color picker tag. Next, I reference the CSS for the color picker component by importing the material theme. I have also added dependent CSS references like buttons, split buttons, and pop-ups. I then add the text-align style to the ID wrapper. Let me save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. See, the color picker component is displayed. When I click the drop-down button, you can see the pop-up showing different colors. From here you can switch to the palette mode by just clicking the mode switcher and then picking the colors you need. The default color on the color picker is green. If you want to change the color on the initial load, use the value property. I define the value property, which accepts 3-6 digit hex color codes. I set a 4-digit hex code to it. In this color code, the last digit represents opacity. Now, the color specified in the value property is set to be selected by default. Notice, the picker mode is enabled on the initial load. The Syncfusion Vue Color Picker also supports palette and inline modes. To demonstrate the palette mode, I set the mode property to palette. You can see the color picker is displayed in palette mode. To render the palette without the drop-down button, I need to enable the inline property by setting it to true. Now, the palette renders without the drop-down button. To disable switching the modes dynamically, I need to hide the mode switcher here. To do that, I set the mode switcher property to false. Now, the color picker renders without the mode switcher. Similarly, you can also hide the apply and cancel buttons shown in the color picker. To hide the control buttons, I simply set the show buttons property to false. Now the color picker component renders without any buttons. By default, the palette contains a color in each tile. If you want to display the color picker with the no color option, you can use the no color property. This property will display the first tile without any color. To demonstrate, I set the no color property to true. Look here, the first tile in the palette is without color. The palette is rendered with a default set of colors. I can also load custom colors into the palette by specifying a set of colors using the preset colors property. First, I declare the object custom colors and add a set of custom colors inside the custom field. I assign this object to the preset colors property. As I am going to add 4 columns to the palette, I set the columns property to 4. To apply custom styles to the palette, I add the before tile render event with the event handler tile render. Inside the methods section, I define the tile render event handler and add the classes eIcons and eCustomTile to the component. Finally, I add required styles like height, width, margin, and content to those classes. Looking here, the palette displays the specified custom colors. Next, I will show you how to apply a color to the target element by choosing it from the color picker. To do that, I add a division element and set its ID to preview. To apply colors chosen from the palette, I add the event change with the event handler on change. This event will be triggered whenever a color is chosen from the color picker. Inside the methods section, I define the event handler. And set the background color to the division element. Then, I define height, width, and default background color for the division element. When I select a color from the color picker now, it is applied to the division element. Next, I will show you how to hide the input area in picker mode. For better clarity, I will remove all the customizations done so far. To hide the input area, I add the CSS class property and set it to eHideValue. And, the picker mode is rendered without the input area. Finally, if I want to disable the color picker component, I set the disabled property to true. Check now, the color picker component is disabled. In this video, I have shown you how to add the color picker component to a Vue application. I also showed you a few of its basic features like setting a value, disabling the switcher mode, displaying no color option and user-defined colors. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.